I was the 100 meters national champion 11 times. I ran for India at the Olympic Games.
Senior journalist and author and news presenter.
I work in a private equity firm. I'm the CEO there.
Today I'm a professor of neurosurgery.
I was very fortunate to be a gold medal winner in the first Olympic in Moscow.
I'm a professor of biology at the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research.
One very important thing that I did, it was setting up the tetanus ward.
Full-time mother, part-time actor, writer, director.
I'm the chairman and chief creative officer of BBDO in India.
Former attorney general.
Retired as a major general of the Indian Army.
I'm chairman of the Godrej Group.
The Society of Jesus is almost 500 years old now. It was started by Saint Ignatius of Loyola, and he gathered a group of his colleagues in a university in Paris, and they decided to dedicate their lives to the service of God. Later on, began to be called the Jesuits. The constitution of the Society of Jesus, that was really a blueprint of what the Jesuits should be. And education very soon came as one of the major aspects of our work.
It effectively laid out the vision that said education is about four things. You want to build the intellect, you want to build a well-rounded personality, you want to build social responsibility in a student, and then you want to build the spiritual side.
What is special about the education and the constitution is the fact that Jesuits would like to educate every section of human society. So we have maybe about 100 institutions of higher learning and many hundreds of schools across the country.
From the 80s onwards, we have set up about 9 secondary schools in the tribal belt, catering to almost about 15,000 Adivasi students.
Because we are trying to build human community, and education is a very important key to that.
This is the desk that I sat at when I did my final BCSE exam, right here.
I had a tremendous education in school. I had many extraordinary teachers, learned a lot from them.
We had great Jesuit priests, people who taught us not only the values, but they also taught us that education had to be all round.
It was a formative part of my life. The work that you had to put in, the honesty that was required.
I mean, if you'd made a mistake or if you did something wrong, to take that in your stride.
It also taught me one more thing, that it's not practice that makes you perfect. It's perfect practice that makes you perfect. It taught us that the world is one.
I was one of the few non-Christian students in the school. I don't remember a single occasion when there was any incident where I was not made to feel part of the group.
I was exposed to all religions, all classes. They never allowed that to come into their education.
It was about the now. It was the people and what they brought to it.
Tremendous vision and real dedication to the cause of education.
I began seeing how academic policies are shaped by people who are committed to education.
There was a certain ambience created by these wonderful institutions run by the Jesuits that really, in a sense, gave me a certain foundation for the rest of my life. Whenever I've been pushed to the wall, I think I've thought of those days.
I still remember we were trailing by a goal, and I just took a long lob, and by mistake it entered the goal. So it was such a great occasion, I always remember that.
The 71 war, which is India's first heliborne operation, I was one of the battle casualties also. I lost my leg on a mine. I told the doctor, do something, please, cut this thing off. And he said, sir, I'm sorry, I don't have anything. So then I said, go and find something. So he went. It took a long time. So I told my batman, I said, Bal Bahadur, where is my kukri? So he said, here it is, sir. I said, cut this off. So he said, sir, why don't you wait for this aremo? So then I said, give me the kukri, and I cut off my leg. And I told him, now go and bury it. What held me in good stead was my value education that I got in school and college. Never be afraid. Never give up. Do whatever you can to the best of your ability and leave the rest to God. I own land in Bangladesh today. 1 foot by 1 foot by 1 foot.
And away they go. Good start.
If it wasn't for St. Mary's, I would never done sport. So I was in the scouts and I was the troop leader. We used to do scouts duty for the inter-school sports. Mr. Padiwala used to finalize the list himself. So-and-so will be with the starter, so-and-so will be at the finish. I didn't find my name. So I go to Mr. Padiwala and tell him, sir, my name is not there. He says, you're going to run inter-school sports. I said, yeah, I know I'm going to run inter-school sports, but I'm not going to get through the heats. I mean, this is inter-schools. And he slapped me across my face. So he says, no. You will win only if you think you can win. If you think you're going to lose, you're going to lose. And I went there and won. And that's when I came into sport. And then that winning became a part of life. And I was probably the only guy who was not scared at the starting line.
My parents realized that I was nearing the final years in school, and they felt that I should be more serious about studies. They stopped me going from training. And Father Juan, he met my parents and he told them, your son is a really great footballer. He has good potential. You send him for the practice. I'll ensure that he doesn't flag in his studies. I think that really turned my entire career around. That pushed me towards hockey. So that care that they imparted to us was instrumental in most of us really transforming ourselves or being impacted at a very young age.
Xavier's gave me roots, and then it gave me wings.
Unless I were a part of that Sangeet Mandal and that play and everything, acting wouldn't have happened to me.
Something here opened it up for me. So this whole feeling of every day I can do more is the feeling I got in this college.
There was a lot of emphasis on moral science, which I found quite good that I had undergone that training in ethics and discipline.
I always owe them a big debt of gratitude. The influence they had on me in cultivating a sense of knowing the difference between right and wrong.
I am what I am largely because of these formative years in school. And I can't be more grateful than I ever can be as I am time.
I think the Jesuits have carved a niche in education that is unparalleled. They're throwing up artists, sportsmen, businessmen. Just the sheer variety of people who have come through the Jesuit system is astounding.
I hope you continue the education that you gave us. I think they're shaping the lives of millions of young children.
I think the Jesuits have shown infinite love. I think they should just keep doing that.
If you just had a hall of fame of St. Xavierites across India, you'd need a stadium. And may the stadium that is full of alumni who graced this country just expand further and further to thousands and thousands of young minds who can be influenced by value-based education.
We'd like to invite the alumni to become part of this mission of ours, to take education where the government is not reaching it, to collaborate with us in whatever way they can, because we need this.
It's important to find other areas of funding, and alumni have shown an interest and have shown a commitment to the institution. So our hope is that in collaboration with our alumni, we will be able to actually expand our educational ventures in India. We have great hopes for the future.